Here the problem is, find Fourier series for the function x minus x square in the interval minus pi to pi. Here they ask a Fourier series for the function x minus x square. So let f of x equal to x minus x square. Take the given function as f of x. So we know Fourier series for the function f of x equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. This is Fourier series expansion to the function f of x. Here a naught, a n, b n are Fourier coefficients we need to determine. To find a naught, the formula is a naught equal to 1 by pi integral f of x dx. For this integral, here they ask Fourier series to the function between the limits minus pi to pi. So the limits are here minus pi to pi. A n equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx. Bn equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx. So these are three Fourier coefficients, a naught, an and bn. Now to find a naught, a naught equal to the formula 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x is here x minus x square dx. It is equal to 1 by pi integral x is x square by 2 minus for x square x cube by 3 limits minus pi to pi. Substitute the limits. In place of x, upper limit pi. So pi square by 2 minus pi cube by 3. Upper limit substitution minus of lower limit substitution. In place of x minus pi. Minus pi whole square. That is simply pi square by 2. Minus in place of x minus pi. That means minus pi cube. Minus pi cube you will get already minus sign. So that pi cube by clearly pi square by 2 minus pi square by 2 cancel. So 1 by pi. Here minus pi by cube. Pi cube by 3. Here also minus pi cube by 3. So minus 2 pi cube by 3. Pi will be cancelled. So it is equal to minus 2 by 3 pi square. Therefore a naught equal to minus 2 by 3 pi square. First Fourier coefficients. Next we need to find out an and bn Fourier coefficients. To find an, an formula equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx equal to 1 by pi minus pi to pi f of x already we know x minus x square cos nx dx. It is equal to evaluate this integral, once observe under the integral algebraic function and trigonometric function. Under the integral, if we have product of algebraic and the trigonometric functions, to evaluate that integral, we go for generalized rule of biparts. The formula is given by generalized rule of biparts means integral uv dx equal to where u and v are functions in terms of x, u is algebraic and v is either trigonometric or exponential function. Under the integral, product of two functions u and v. U is if algebraic function and v is either trigonometric or exponential function. In that situation, to evaluate this integral, we go for generalized rule of biparts. The formula is given by uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus and so on, where u dash, u double dash and so on are successive derivatives of u. V1, V2, V3 are successive integrations of v. Actually, this is infinite formula, but we are choosing u as algebraic function. So, for finite number of steps, if you do the differentiation to algebraic function, we will get constant and after that zero, so that the infinite formula will be stopped. That we are going to see in the problem. Under the integral, clearly algebraic and the trigonometric functions. So, take u equal to x minus x square, v equal to cos nx, u dash equal to 1 minus 2x, u double dash equal to minus 2 and u triple dash equal to 0. So, if we take algebraic as u, for u if you do the derivatives, finite number of steps, you will get 0. And for v, integrations. V1 means integral of v, integral cos. Integral of cos is sin nx divided by n. And v2 equal to, again to this one integration. Already here 1 by n, you will get constant. For sin nx, integration is minus cos nx by n. So, it is equal to minus cos nx by n square. V3 equal to, for this one integration, cos integration is sin. So, minus sin nx by n cube. So, generalized rule of biparts means integral uv dx equal to uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4, like that it will be generated. So, according to the problem, an equal to 1 by pi. Now, this step, this after this equation, we will get integral uv dx equal to uv1. U is x minus x square. V1 is sin nx by n uv1 minus u dash 1 minus 2x. Just keep this formula in mind, observe these symbols and substitute here. Uv1 minus u dash v2. V2 is minus cos nx by n square. Uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash, that is minus 2, v3, that is minus sin nx by n cube. And uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 and after that minus u triple dash v4. For u algebraic function, if we do the third time derivative, it will be 0. 1 by pi. Now we had to substitute upper limit pi in place of x. Once observe, already we know sin n pi equal to 0. We know sin n pi, sin 2 n pi equal to 0. Remember these values in mind. And cos n pi equal to minus 1 whole power n. These are very very important. So, if you substitute upper limit pi in the sin, you will get sin n pi. That means this value is 0. So, that the whole value 0. So, 0 minus minus into minus plus 1 minus 2 pi in place of x. Upper limit pi. So, 1 minus 2 pi. Cos n pi. Cos n pi value minus 1 whole power n by n square. Here sine function again. In place of x pi, sine n pi we are observing, so that the next term also 0. This is upper limit substitution. Minus of lower limit substitution. In place of x, minus pi. We know that sine is an odd function. That is, a sine of minus theta equal to minus sine theta. So, sine of minus n pi means minus sine n pi. So, already we know sine n pi is 0. So, according to that, in place of x, if you substitute the lower limit minus pi, you will get minus sine n pi. That is, sine of minus sine n pi 0. So, that first term, whole term 0. Now, here, minus minus plus 1 in place of x upper limit minus pi, that means 1 plus 2 pi. And we know cos of minus theta means cos theta itself. Cos of minus theta, cos theta. So in place of x, if you substitute minus pi, you will get cos of minus n pi. That means cos n pi itself means the value minus 1 whole power n. Already we used this minus sign here, minus into minus plus. So cos n pi only we are going to see up here. So minus 1 whole power n by n square. Next, in this sine function minus pi. So clearly according to this step 0. So, equal to 1 by pi, 1 minus 2 pi minus 1 whole power n by n square minus here 1 plus 2 pi minus 1 whole power n by n square. Here 1 into this term, here also minus 1 into this term. So, 1 minus 1 will be cancelled. So, 1 by pi, this term cancelled. Minus 2 pi, here also minus 2 pi. You will get minus 4 pi minus 1 whole power n by n square. Pi pi cancelled. So, minus 4 into minus 1 whole power n by n square. This is an. Up to now we find a0, an. Now we are finding bn. To find bn, formula is 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sine nx dx. So 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x is x minus x square sine nx dx. Now, under the integral, the product of algebraic and the trigonometric functions. So, we go for generalized rule of biparts. So, here u equal to x minus x square, v equal to sine nx. For u derivatives, u dash 1 minus 2x, u double dash minus 2, u triple dash 0. v1 equal to integral of sine is minus cos nx by n. v2 equal to, for cos integration is sine nx by n square. And v3 equal to, for sine integration is minus cos, so minus minus plus, so cos nx by n cube. So according to generalized rule of biparts, here integral uv dx equal to uv1, u into v1, so x minus x square into v1 is minus cos nx by n uv1 minus u dash 1 minus 2x into v2. minus sin nx by n square. Uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 cos nx by n cube. Uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4. As already u triple dash is 0, the formula will be stopped. The limits are from minus pi to pi equal to 1 by pi. In place of x, upper limit pi. You are observing cos n pi. Cos n pi value we know. Cos n pi equal to minus 1 whole power n. So that in place of x pi. So pi minus pi square. Minus into cos n pi is minus 1 whole power n by n minus. Here sin n pi we will get. So value 0. So whole term 0. Next minus 2 into in place of x pi cos n pi minus 1 whole power n by n cube. This is upper limit substitution minus of lower limit substitution. Here you have one minus sign, that means pi square minus pi into in place of x minus pi cos of minus theta cos theta, according to that minus 1 whole power n by n, and here you will get 0, and here minus 2 into minus 1 whole power n by n cube 1 by pi. Here pi square minus pi into minus 1 whole power n by n, because of this minus sign 0. Next term minus 2 minus 1 whole power n by n cube, and minus of this one pi square minus pi minus 1 whole power n by n minus minus plus. Therefore, on doing the simplification, we will get Fourier coefficient bn equal to minus 2 minus 1 whole power n by an. Therefore, we got the three Fourier coefficients a0 equal to minus 2 by 3 pi square, an equal to minus 4 minus 1 whole power n by n square, bn equal to minus 2 minus 1 whole power n by n square by not n square n. So we got the three Fourier coefficients. Therefore, Fourier expansion f of x equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. This is a Fourier series expansion of f of x, and a naught, a n, b n are Fourier coefficients. We determined those. So minus 2 by 3 pi square by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity a n minus 4 minus 1 whole power n by n square cos nx plus b n is minus 2 minus 1 whole power n by n into sin nx. Now do the simplification. Minus pi square by 3 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. Here minus 4 is free from n. You may write down outside of sigma like this. That is minus pi square by 3 minus 4 sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole power n square by cos nx, and later this sigma for this function also minus 2 sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole power n by sin nx. Here f of x is our problem x minus x square. So this is the required Fourier series expansion to the function x minus x square.